has been in development for so many years, how many versions of the script have you seen?
We love this question.
A lot. I find it fascinating how many versions. Because this is our first, this is the first movie ever. And, well, I don't know, yeah. So it was amazing to me how many different versions, where we started. We always knew, like, where we were going to start, where we were going to end up, you know, tent poles in the middle. But, like, the way we got there changed at least dramatically, twice maybe. And so it was really fun to see that it finally got to, like, where we were super happy with it.
Well, all three, Nora and I wrote the script, Bernard and I directed the movie, and it is a this is a group of people who loves to work. We are very, very enjoy the if you give us time, we will always do another draft.
Yeah.
And that's just I think it's baked into our DNA. And then we also wind each other up and, you know, stay up late and text each other new ideas. So when we were given any opportunity to tweak the script, we took it. It's really fun.
We want a note. Give us a note and we'll do another version. Yeah.
Yep. And same with Bernard for the board.
Yeah, well, the thing is, for every version of the script, we actually drew it too, because, you know, Loren and Nora would do the temps. We didn't always have the cast to record every version. So the beauty was these guys would just record it and then we would draw every version, so we'd get to actually see it too, which is a big part of it.
Yeah. Is that a draw? All these drawings that went away.
None.
Like that.
No, I mean, who knows? A good idea sometimes manages to resurface and be reborn. We have that on the series all the time too. You try never to throw anything valuable away. All of these little bits and pieces tend to get recycled and sorted through for everything. So some pieces may show up in the series, and who knows? Maybe some pieces will show up in a future movie. But it wasn't like we had a sequel that we cut. Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
But we talked about stuff that we were like, oh, we can't fit it in this movie. We have to, hopefully we'll get to do another one so we can put it in there.
Yeah.
Or maybe the next season of Oscar.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So when you're doing this, and you said at the beginning that it was going to be like a musical when you first talked about this years ago, and now it's a mashup. But what is it mostly?
Ha! I mean, we tried to make it really not all one thing. I think it's fair to say it's mostly Bob's Burgers, the movie. Not to be cute about it, but I mean, we didn't want to make it too much of a musical because that wouldn't be true to the show. We didn't want to make it too much of a mystery because we wanted it to be funny and we wanted it to be hearty and character driven. So we had to mash it in a way where you don't feel one ingredient dominates over the others. Would you say that's true?
I think so. And then, I mean, at one point we had actually ambitions for more songs, and then, but story sometimes got in the way. You'd start pulling them out, and like we had to sort of fit it all in. So it had to, we didn't want to force stuff in if we didn't have to. So I think we did the right amount.
We hope.
In the panel, yes. You mentioned that, like, the sidewalk craft and stuff like that. But are there going to be a lot of Easter eggs from seasons 1 through 12 that are scattered throughout the movie group? Hardcore fans.
A lot sounds like a lot.
It's also like just stuff that we know that the fans are wondering about that we get into. So hopefully that, like, which is less Easter egg and more just like questions that we've gotten a lot at events, and so we hope to like delve into some of those, you know, areas, explore those areas.
Yeah,
and we've also, it is in a fixed time and place, so a lot of the series, you'll see stuff that will involve the movie, and after the movie too, a lot of stuff that in the aftermath of the movie is going to be, you'll see in the series. So you'll be able to pinpoint between which episode the premiere was, is the idea.
And is the movie accessible for people who don't watch Bob's Burgers?
Yes, I'm so glad you asked that. From the very beginning, we were aware that if we just made a fan movie, if we just made a movie for the folks who watch the show, it not only does it leave some possible members of the audience out, but it also isn't probably as good a movie. Those movies are fun if you, I guess, if you know all the characters and you can just, you know, jump right in. But I think to make a really good movie, it has to stand on its own. That's the definition of a movie. It can't just be some add-on, some extra that only speaks to one portion of the population. It should work for anyone who cares to sit down and watch it for 90-something minutes.
And we really hope it does.
Yeah, well, I mean, we want to hear from you. You know, after you see it, if you've never seen the series, reach out and tell us, you know, if we succeeded. That's the goal.
If you liked it.
Oh, yeah, don't tell us how much you didn't like it. We can't handle that.
We actually explore that in an episode.
Not what they will grow up to be, but what they think they might grow up to be.
Yeah. We'll never know what they're going
to
be.
I feel that it's, yeah, I feel, like, for me anyway, it feels like cheating to decide, like, oh, I know, I'm the showrunner, I kind of know. It definitely goes into kind of this particular field that I'm interested in. I think it's fun to resist the urge because we have to stay in this time frame. And so in a way that, you know, it's cheating to have a card in your back pocket where you're like, I know how it turns out. Right. We showed it. We, you know, I think it's fun for us to write from that same point of view as the audience watching it.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.